And I hope you all can appreciate this is not a very simple model. In some ways it is, but in other ways it's not. There's a lot of complex surfaces on it. And I like to kind of challenge myself and challenge the community in showing some complex things in SpaceClam and not just sticking with cookie cutter examples. Now let's go to that volume extract tool, because there's a number of things I might want to do with this model, right? I might want to extract out a core, and the volume extract tool is perfect for that. Now last time I selected an option to merge everything together, and this time I don't. I'm looking for just the core. If you pretend that this is a sand casting, then that's going to be my core that's made out of sand, and it creates it that simple, right? Now, from my understanding, if you have a sand casting and you have a core, you need to have some kind of extension on the ends of it so it's properly supported in the rest of the part. And here's where my terminology, where I don't know it all that well, but any of you guys that work in the sand casting realm, you know exactly what I'm talking about. I need some kind of extension over here. Let's just draw a simple circle out. Easily define that and go right into the pull tool and start making it. Now I think I want this to be about 10 millimeters. So it's simple to put some intelligence into a model. Notice those are different colors. It didn't merge itself together. That's just because things are not residing at the same level in the tree. That's really not a big deal. The combine tool quickly merges those things together. And I've got my extension. Let's put a round on it, or a couple of rounds actually, and define it as 2.5 millimeters. See how easy it is to put rounds on models? You just dynamically drag or put a value in, and the rounds are instantly done. That's actually the default behavior when you're working on edges in SpaceClam. Now let's do the exact same thing over on the other side. We'll put in another circle right around the center. We'll define that diameter. I don't know, something like 60 looks adequate to me, and extend it out another 10 millimeters. Finally, we want a couple of rounds on those edges, and we'll call them 2.5 millimeters. Yeah, I could call them 3, but 2.5 just seemed to be all right for me. Now, this is your core. From my understanding, you need to have some kind of a core box, right? Well, let's go ahead and create that. Now, one thing I should preface all of this with is, although this model may not be, in fact, symmetric around all four, I'm going to assume there's symmetry all over the model. And so one quarter of the model, working on that should suffice instead of working on all of it all at once. Now, I think the direction, if I can draw on the screen for a moment, the direction of my pull is going to be straight up and down, or in the y-axis. Okay, so let's sort of make that assumption from here on out. Now, if I wanted to build a core box around this, here's where the volume enclosure tool really shines. It builds a box right around your model. Now anybody can build a box around the model, but interestingly enough, it hollows out the inside of it, and so if I hide the original core, you're left with a perfect cutout. Now, I need to probably chop this in half, and that's for manufacturability. And by the way, I'm only going to focus on kind of the theoretical and not completing a full design and having all the runners and all the connection points and bolts. All those things are pretty well established. They're simple to do, but these are where the problems really exist for people, is creating all that complex geometry. Notice I'm able to do that in just a couple of button clicks. Now let me take those two bodies. Let me sort of drive it home here and make these opaque, and then separate them out. This is kind of where the fun begins. If I move one up and move one down, you see exactly what I made. There's your core box. Now, I'm not going to bother changing the colors, but I think you guys get the example and see what I'm going for.